let's talk about Finch for just a second. Underrated hero for Australia this World Cup he's been?
A much needed hero. for Australia. You know, and if you look at their tournament, it was Nathan Coulter-Nile who provided the impetus to this side, and the fact that Aaron Finch was in like unbelievable form coming into this tournament, right? So, you know, his form was much needed for Australia's hopes to change.
For Warner as well, is his form very important to Warner as well, coming back into the game after a year?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Because that's your foundation, right? The foundation is set from there. So you need both of them to complement each other. And if you look at the tournament, even the way it's been played and the way the two of them have played in the tournament, it's always been Finch who has gone on the attack as compared to David Warner. And that gives Warner time, because he's coming back to international cricket after 12 months. So it gives him time to kind of assess and, you know, like feel a part of it again. And now he's got a couple of hundreds. So he'll be in a good space right now as well. And I think Finch has played a huge role in helping him come back into the form that he has in this level of cricket.
And Finch loves playing against England. There are some oppositions, isn't it, Zach? Some oppositions just get out a little more from you than others. And I mean, this England-Australia rivalry is no less yesterday, you mentioned, than the India-Pakistan rivalry.
Yeah.
And somehow, this really gets the best out of Finch.
Yes, I think that's what the numbers are suggesting. But I feel that if England has done their homework right, and they have the right resource to actually tackle Finch in this particular match, because Jofra's strength is that. You know, Jofra's strength is actually hitting the deck and then the ball goes back in. And you've seen how Bhuvneshwar has troubled Finch. So if England has done their homework right, I'm looking forward to this, that first half an hour.
In terms
of what are the plans? Yeah. You know, what are the plans which will be used and the tactics which will be used against Finch and Warner both in terms of that bowling meeting, how that had gone. Because if there is help in the wicket and Jofra's natural angle which is coming back in, I think he should trouble Finch if he gets the length right. And the length has to be a little fuller than what he normally bowls.
Yeah.
If he's able to do that, you know, you may see early wickets today.
Yeah, because they haven't had early wickets against Australia. The opening combination has ensured, I mean, all the matches they've played, only once have they got out in the power play. That's a staggering statistic, isn't it?
Yeah, they have been setting up a great foundation for Australia, and it's been one of the reasons that Australia have gone on to win games, because that foundation has been very solid. They've taken their time in a lot of games, but for me, in this game, what I as a batsman will also be watching is if the technical changes that Aaron Finch has made to his batting actually stands up against the quality of bowling that England have. Because they not just have really express quick bowlers, they have guys who move the ball, seam, you know, what's his name?
Mark Wood.
Not Mark Wood, the other one. Wokes.
Yeah.
Facebook. So, same fade.
They've got a Wokes, they've got a Stokes, they've got a Folks who plays in their test team, you know.
So, he sort of moves the ball beautifully off the seam both ways. So, I want to see if actually his technique holds up against these guys. Because it'll be very interesting for me as a batsman to see. Because I understand the changes he's made as to why he wants to, you know,
cover the off stump, sort of move a little more.
Not, in fact, actually, he's moving just his back foot.
The back foot.
Right? Yeah, but his left leg stays in, like, wherever it is, because he wants room for the bat to come through.
Yeah.
So he's made that change. I used to do that earlier, but I used to get out LBW a lot because my leg used to go across a lot. So I used to bat like that. So I know that there are downsides to that technique, but I'd be really interested to see if that actually holds up against a quality bowling attack like England.